So, you just put brakes on your first and second generation Cummins Dodge 3/4 or 1 ton, and now you've got so bad a brake shake that you just can't stand it. Well, I'll tell you what happened. Because of a video by Brian at BCBLOC02 or B Block, he shows an in-depth going about all this. When you replace the drums on these, this is a Dana 70, and coming down the assembly line when they manufacture these, the machines center everything up. A lot of you guys already know how you knock out the studs, drop the hub off of it, put it on the new drum. These have a cone on the inside, a sheet metal cone. You have to knock it out of the old drum, put it into this drum, set your hub on top of it, but the shoulders of the studs in the drum are loose. They're not a tight fit. So consequently, once you drive them into or draw them into the hub, the drum is not concentric or centered with the hub. This makes big problems, like it did for me. So after finding Brian's video, he shows how to do it, and the difference between what he does and what I'm going to do here is he has a dial indicator and I don't. So his video just weren't redneck enough. So if you don't have a dial indicator, you got to put all your studs back in, follow the whatever procedure. If you go watch Brian's video, like I said, he goes through the whole thing. And I'll leave a link in the description. So what I've done here, you can hear that. This is a magnetic base for a dial indicator, and all I have is just riding just above the drum. So it's not out of round, it's off center. So right there is where it makes contact, because I'm listening to it. And right there is where it stops. So bring that to the center. He only uses a 3-pounder, and that just ain't redneck enough. What you need is a splitting maul. And you have to hit the drum, not the hub, like I just did. Ain't that like magic? It's making contact all the way around. Now I've already knocked this into, this was probably 30 thousandths out when I started. But I wasn't gonna turn the camera on and make a video until I knew it was gonna work. What would be the point? All you're hearing there is just brake shoes. You can eyeball the thing. Find out where your high spot is. So you can hear I got just a little bit. I can do the same thing by the shy spot. Just touches there. Just touches there. That's not enough to worry about. But when you get to this point, that's the center between the two. If you go 180, because it's not easy to swing up from the bottom, you can see all my dimples where I've been doing this. Probably wouldn't take a whole lot. There you go, all the way around. It's a beautiful thing. So if you've been working on stuff for years and you think you're a decent mechanic and you run into something like this and you're just pulling your hair out, this is why. And there's no procedure in the manual to do this. As far as I know, I don't have a manual, so I haven't been able to look at it. But talking with Brian, he says no, there is no procedure in the manual. So once you put your wheel on here, tighten everything down, you won't have a problem at all. So there you go, there's your quick tip. Centering new brake drums in a Dana 70. All right, go check out Brian's channel, BC Block 02.